Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn a new lesson, that is environmental attention. Okay, in this lesson we are going to learn about environmental issues. I hope you are doing good. Let's go for the lessons. Okay, lately many countries, organizations and international firms have been presenting research reports and data. So many countries gathering together and they were searching about that environmental, and after that, after research everything, they found 10 top 10 problems we are facing through the environmental. These are related to the immediate environmental issues that we need to pay attention to. So these top 10 environmental issues we are facing, that if we are having more sunlight, then also it is problem, and heavy rain, it is also create the problems. And if now we are in winter, in this time also we are facing problem. So after researching, okay, they found how we are getting, which type of problem we are getting from the environmental. Okay, so now that top 10 names we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, so these are the top 10 environmental issues we are facing now. So the first one, climate change. Okay, so climate change, yes dear. So today it was very cold, is no? But tomorrow we don't know, maybe whether it will be sunlight or not. So yesterday it was sunlight, today it was foggy. So suddenly the climate changing, in that also we are facing many problems, because according to the climate, suddenly our body will not support. Okay, so now it is cold, after the if it is some, so we are having some health problem also. So again, climate changes we are facing that type of problem. And second one, ecosystems and endangered species. Okay, and ecosystems and endangered species, in this we cannot expect maybe today it will rain, today it will sunlight, today it will foggy. So we cannot expect in that, and we cannot decide what will be today or tomorrow. That according to the ecosystems, how the earth is moving, then the climate change will be. After that, deforestation and pollution. So pollution, how we have, there are four types of pollutions: land pollution, water pollution, air pollution and noise pollution. In this pollution also, it creates many problems. If it is air pollution, we cannot get good air. If it is noise pollution, it disturbs educations, and it creates the problem in our ears. And land pollution, we know that. And water pollution, if it is water dirty, we cannot drink. Okay, so we should avoid these pollutions. So fourth one is pollutions, and fifth one, water scarcity and water pollution. Yes, we should save the water, we should save the water, we should not spoil the waters, and we should not waste the water. And water pollution, and if we have a drinking water, in that water we should not throw anything else. Okay, so water is a precious one, so we should take care of it, we should not waste it, and we should save the waters. And loss of biodiversity, overpopulation. Loss of biodiversity and overpopulation. If it is overpopulation, we cannot get space. No, if it is overpopulation, you just think in that more dirty, we cannot get good water, we cannot get good space, we cannot get enough space to sit, to around, we cannot keep garden, trees, okay? So overpopulation, that also we should control it. And waste disposal. So we are using paper cup, paper plate, okay? And according to the waste, we are having green cabbage, yellow cabbage, and red cabbage, okay? So in that, we know that in green cabbage, which type of waste we have to put, and yellow and red. According to that, we should throw the waste. We should not throw anywhere. In the dustbin, we have to throw blue dustbin, green, yellow, red. So, in that four type of dustbin, we throw the different type of waste for food garbage and polythene covers and plastics. Okay, so we should divide our wastes and we should throw the particular dustbin. And land management and urban sprawl. So in land, we should not, we are throw the wastes on the land and we are fire that wastes on the land, no? Because of that only, we are facing the land pollution. We should avoid in that. And public health. So, these type of, if we control these nine environmental issues, then we will maintain the public health also. Public means in that myself also and you are also is there. So, we should not throw the dustage and dust on the road or on the garden, okay? We should not throw the wastage anywhere. According to the dustbin, okay, we have separate dustbin, in that we have to put. Okay, so these 10, we are having top 10 environmental issues we are facing right now. And first one is, once again, I read the name of the top 10 environmental issues. The first one is climate change. And second one is ecosystems and endangered species and deforestation. Fourth one is pollution. Fifth one is water scarcity and water pollution. And sixth one is loss of biodiversity. And seventh one is overpopulation. Eighth one is waste disposal. And ninth one is land management and urban sprawl. And tenth one is public health. And shall we move to the next lesson, that is lesson Green Crushers, lesson 15, okay? So far we learned lesson 14. In that lesson, we learned top 10 environmental issues we are facing now. And in this lesson, Green Crushers 15, we are going to learn some achieved persons. Some achieved persons we are going to learn in this lesson. So the first one, and we should identify the person and we should write the person's name here. So in your book, you have the help box according to, okay, with the help of that help box, we are going to write the answers here. So let's first we know the persons. And here we have some clue about the particular person. So the first one, when she was unable to give birth to a child, she started planting and raising banyan trees. So she is that girl, when she come to know she cannot give birth to child, okay? So she did not upset that, she did not think like that, I cannot give birth to the child, Okay? So she did not care about that. She thinks that I cannot give birth to the child. So instead of that, I can plant, okay, more trees. So she started planting the plants. First, she started planting the banyan trees. Okay? She planted around 385 banyan trees between. Okay? So she, after that, she planted 385 banyan trees. So in particular place, which place to which place, that also we are having here. So in that particular place, she planted 385 banyan trees. So that place name is Ulikal and Kodur in Magadi Taluka. So in Magadi Taluka, Ulikal to from there to Kodur, in that particular place, she was planting 385 banyan trees. Ramanagar district at her own expense and then took care of them as her own children. So after planting, she did not live as it is. So she was take care of that 385 banyan trees as her own children. How we are take care of our children's, like that is she take care of that banyan trees. Not only one banyan tree or two banyan trees, 385 banyan trees she took care of every day. She was cleaning that trees, she was pour the waters. And since then has planted thousands of trees in 66 years. She was honored with the Padmasri. So in 60, now she was up to 66 years. She was planting many trees, thousand trees she was planting, and she was take care of the tree also. Every day she used to pour the waters, she clean up that. Every day she went and look at the trees. Okay, so it is not easy thing. So she never upset that, she never think that I cannot give birth the child. But instead of one child or two child, she was planting thousands banyan tree and she was take care as her own child. Okay, so now who is she? What is her name? Let's see the answer now. So her name is Salamurda Timaka. Her name is Salamurda and Timaka. She is the girl, and after that she was awarded Padmasri from the government. So that is the first one. And second one, he is popularly known as the Clutchium Man for his efforts to save and make artificial glaciers in Ladakh. So he is a famous person. Everyone knows him and as a glacier man for his efforts and for his efforts, for his hard work, for his interest. Okay, the people gave the nickname to him as a glacier man for his efforts to save and make artificial glaciers in Ladakh. And his name is Jamuna Tudu. His name is Jamuna Tudu. So the first one is Samurda Tamaka. She was not able to give birth child and she was planting many trees. Okay? And he gives effect in artificials. Okay? And because of his hard work and his intelligence, he's talented, the people gave a nickname to him, that is the Clutchium Man. And third one, she is a Padmasri winner and has devoted a major part of her life to protecting and nurturing trees. She had waged a war against wood poachers and timber merchants to protect trees in the forest. She has been nicknamed Lady Tarzan for her affinity with plants and trees. So, and she is also honor awarded for Padmasri. So, first one, who cannot give child? Her name is Samutha Tumaka. She is also honored in the Padmasri Award, and she also honored the Padmasri Award, and she devoted a major part of her life protecting and nurturing trees. She had waged a war against wood poachers and timber merchants to protect trees. So she is protect the trees, those who are cutting the trees, those who are doing against of trees. So she was protect the trees and she was save the nature. Because of that, she awarded her as a Padmasri winner. Okay, so her name is Sundarlal Bahunga. She is saving the nature and she was protecting the trees. And fourth one, he is a lawyer and an environmentalist. He is a lawyer also, and also he is interested to doing environmentalist. Okay, who pioneered legal activism of environment? So those who are doing illegal activities of against of nature, so he was fight for that. Okay, so protection which lead to the closure of more than 200 industrial unit around the Taj Mahal. So she was have the 200 industrial units around the Taj Mahal. So he only made that gardens, trees, natural. Okay, his name is M.C. Mehta. So he was a lawyer and also he is the environmentalist person. Okay, the next one is, she was uneducated but had the capacity to mobilize the women of Uttarakhand. So she was not going for the school. She did not know anything about education. She was uneducated. Then also she knows and she had a capacity to know each and everything about girl. Okay, and she was protect their natural heritage, and she was the protect the nature heritage. She was one of the main leader of the Chipko movement, and she was one of the main leader in the Chipko movement. She had a capacity to fight against of who is doing nature. She was she had a capacity, and she is a bold girl. Okay, and she was the main leader in the Chipko movement. Her name is Gaurav Devi. And sixth one is, he is a businessman who also works as an activist in Himachal Pradesh for representation in the state, and is setting up water harvesting projects and leopard conservation center too. And he is a businessman who also works as an activist of in Himachal Pradesh for representation in the state, and is setting up water harvesting. And he is a businessman, and he is only found the harvesting of water. Okay, and he projects and leopard conservation center to also, and the harvesting water procedure he gave to that harvesting projects and leopard conservation center too. And he is the person who found the pure water, harvesting water in the land. His name is Tilka Vij. And seventh one is, He is a bus conductor from Tamil Nadu who has single-handed planted more than 38,000 trees in 26 years. So he is a bus conductor. Conductor, you know, who is helped in the bus, who is the clean the bus. We call that person as a conductor. So he is not a businessman and he is not a educated person. He is a common man and he is working as a bus conductor. He is from Tamil Nadu, who has single-handedly planted more than 38,000 trees in 26 years. So he is in 26, he is very young. In that particular period, he was planting more trees, 38,000 trees. He has made efforts to save wildlife and has spread awareness about conservation. So he is not live that he is planting, okay, I planted, I save the trees, I save the earth. He is not stopped in that. He was give awareness to the people to plant the more trees, okay? And he is doing many awareness program also about the trees. He order many conservations. So his name is M.Y. Yoganathan. His name is M.Y. Yoganathan. Thank you, dear children. I hope the lesson 14 we learn top 10 environmental issues, and in this lesson we learn 7 achieved persons names and about them. I hope you understand the lessons, learn well. Thank you and have a nice day.